Is a man stronger if he cries or if he never cries? Is he stronger if he shows his emotions, shows his vulnerability, or doesn't show his emotions? This is a really somber and polarizing topic, and that's why I'm taping this in black and white. I wanted to do a deeper dive in this, so I interviewed people on how do you feel about this? Boy moms, men, women, how do you feel about why boys are brought up not to show their emotions, and whether or not do you think it's healthy? I'm Dr. Elise Briscoe, and I like to do a deeper dive into what affects our happiness and health. And our mental and emotional health is a big part of our daily lives and certainly part of our confidence and well-being. So watch, please comment below on your feelings. Whatever you add helps somebody else who is suffering in silence with this issue, or they may be feeling that it is great to be unemotional and that makes you stronger. Stay tuned and thanks for watching. I'm with my friend Mark, who's also a model. And Mark, we're doing this for men's mental healthness. And I just want to know, why is it that boys are discouraged from showing their emotions? And did that happen to you? And do you feel that it's healthy or not?
As far as emotions, what are you referring to? Like as far as relationships or
showing sadness, anger, things like that.
Nowadays I feel like men kind of take pride into being a man. Being a man is where you don't really show emotions. I'm not gonna lie, I'm actually kind of like that. I don't show emotions at all because I feel like it makes you less of a man. I feel like the man kind of just a real man keeps his emotions into himself. And maybe like if someone's like close to him, whether it's a girl or family, I guess like that's when they can open up. But as far as like everybody else like around them, like if it's like a random people, me personally as a man, I would keep my emotions to myself just because I don't know how I'm gonna be seen. I feel like I'm gonna be judged. I don't really need to like, I don't need to be like, you know, into that category at all. So I feel like keeping my emotions to myself is always safer, and to me at least. And I think that's why men kind of don't really show emotions a lot. So.
Boy, that was super insightful. And thank you for being so genuine and honest about that, because that helps other people understand why they are the way they are. So yes. Thank you again, Mark.
I believe they should like start sprouting out and actually showing emotions just so that people can understand what they're going through, because sometimes they'll go through something and they're keeping it to themselves, but at the same time they're very snappy with everybody and very like, you know what I'm saying, it's they're having bad days all the time because it's so much kept in. So I feel like feeling like, you know, making this better, you know, you always make it like trying to make a better world. So like doing that, I feel like men should always speak up, because honestly that leads to a lot of like bad things all the time. So that's how I feel about that, to be honest.
Thank you again, Mark. I'm with my very handsome friend, Kojak, who's a model. And Kojak, where are you from?
I'm half Greek, half Syrian.
And so I want to get your perspective on why is it that men and boys are discouraged from showing their emotions, and do you feel it's healthy or not?
Actually, that's a very deep question. Very, very deep question. So I guess showing that as a man is kind of like, as my culture is more feel like weird. Yeah, it makes you feel like a man as weak to show his emotion for someone, like everyone. Except like a few people, you know, if you have like a close friend, you know, that one who's grow up with you, probably you have like 90% you can show this your emotion, but mostly as a man, no, you're not showing that, you know, because that's how we create as a man, like really understand the other man, that's a man world.
Do you
think
that's healthy or not?
I believe if you used to, and if you know from the when you are kids, that I feel like, yeah, it's healthy.
Okay.
Because this is something like you're not like coming like it's a new like, but something like you grow up with it, you know. So
I get it. It's interesting perspective. No one else has brought that up, that be strong on the exterior and the outside, but with your friends, that's when you can express your emotions. So to me, sounds like a balance, so
yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Hi everyone, recently I watched an impactful video by Dr. Elise Briscoe discussing Movember, the month dedicated to raising awareness for men's health. She delved into the reasons behind men's reluctance to express themselves and asked questions whether such reluctance was healthy. I'd like to share my perspective on this. While the video highlighted the societal pressure on men to always exhibit strength and avoid vulnerability, I believe the solution goes beyond societal pressures. I absolutely agree with all my friends who had a variety of opinions in that video. I, however, also feel that individuals of any gender, men, women, should learn to be fearless, stand up for themselves, embrace their true selves, and feel comfortable expressing their thoughts and emotions. It is not a problem, it is not an issue to be vulnerable. What is needed is to be able to fight back. Creating a nurturing environment starts at home, within our closest circles. It involves spending quality time with our loved ones, asking about how was your day, understanding their feelings, encouraging open communications and conversations, cultivating a safe space where everyone feels free to express themselves is crucial in demonstrating care and support for each other, a trait fundamental to humanity. Dr. Elise Briscoe's content is commendable. I just love her work. I admire her success as a fashion model, as an artist. As an artist myself, I relate to expressing fearlessly despite any judgments that come my way. I believe we should all embrace this fearless expression. Thank you so much for listening through my viewpoint.